Hi, and welcome to the Snagit 2019 reveal. I'm Kelsey, and I'm going to be your host today. With me is Tony Dunkel, Snagit's General Manager.
Hi, everyone.
Today, we're going to talk about Snagit 2019 and all the release has to offer. But before we get to that, Tony, could you share with us where you see the use of visuals in communication heading?
Yeah, you bet. You know, a topic that we hear, we see, we experience on a daily basis is this increase in digital transformation, really both in our corporate and academic environments. And so much of what we all do in our work life is shifting from analog and paper to now being driven by technology in one way or another. And that shift is creating a massive need for technology training, support, documentation. And here at TechSmith, we've proven through extensive research that the use of images and videos greatly improves both the comprehension and the efficiency of that shift. So in that light, we've taken big strides in this new release to address this transformational shift, and we're here and excited to share it with you all today.
Thanks for those insights, Tony. Speaking of Snagit 2019, could you help explain this new release cadence and how that aligns with the shift in digital transformation that you mentioned?
Yeah, you bet. Well, they certainly go hand in hand, that's for sure. Historically, we've delivered a new version of Snagit, every 2 or 3 years, which typically aligns with the pace of new technology releases, such as operating systems and technologies like that. However, the pace of that's increased substantially. And to ensure that we support that shift, we've increased our own release cadence to ensure that we're always supporting users' needs. So in that spirit, Snagit 2019 marks our transition to annual releases. But of course, the big question is, when can people get their hands on this new release? So in terms of the release date, Tuesday, October 23rd is the date that you want to mark in your calendars. That's the date that Snagit 2019 will be available to the general public.
Great. For those that are still joining our stream, welcome. We're talking about the upcoming release of Snagit 2019. At the end of this demo, we will talk you through how you can go about purchasing this new version. But for now, without further ado, let's get into the demo.
And much like we did with Snagit 2018, innovation this round is focused on a core set of users. That's people who document, support, teach, or explain technology. That could be an informal part of your job, or it might be the only thing you do all day. Either way, we have new functionality for you in Snagit 2019 that will help you communicate quickly and compellingly with visuals. I'm going to share 3 highlights today. The first one that we're going to talk about is combining images. So whenever we survey or talk with customers, the number one thing they do with Snagit is use it to explain a series of steps. Often that's as simple as click here, open that menu, click there. It's kind of 1, 2, 3. And we've all used Snagit this way. So we've actually done a lot of work over the years to make this task quick and painless. So we've added things like stamps, text boxes, step tool, ways to really visualize that sequence. But combining a series of screenshots into a single image is still not as easy as it could be.
We wanted to take a step back and see how we can make it super efficient to get from a set of screenshots to one image that shows the whole series of steps in an easy to read layout.
Kind of a paint by numbers approach. You select the images that represent each step, and then Snagit does the hard work of generating the step guide.
I'm going to demo the Windows version of Snagit. So here are 3 captures of a website. In previous versions, I'd have to drag each of these up to the first image, resize the canvas, center everything, and then add callouts. But here we simplified the process while giving you some control. So I'm going to select each of these. I'm holding the control key here to multi-select, and I'm going to combine the images. As you can see, we have this dialogue, but I'm just going to combine to show you the quick process that we have. And now you can see these 3 images combined in the new image. It's ready to share if I wanted to quickly help someone out. We have these numbered steps that are automatically applied. Now, what if I wanted to provide more information for each step and create a standalone guide? Here's how we'd do that. So I selected each of these images and combined again. And if I'm not happy with the order of the images, I can easily rearrange them by dragging them to their correct place. I'll give it a title. And then next up, I'm going to adjust the theme. So I'm going to select the theme to stay on brand at my organization. It will automatically choose from your theme colors here. And I'm going to set a white background. Now I'm going to select a different brand color for my numbered steps. Let's give a little more context to each of these steps by adding captions to each of the images. This will make it so the image can live on its own without needing any accompanying text or explanation. I can just share a link if I choose to later. All right, so here we are. If you're not completely happy, these are still editable Snagit objects. They can be changed and tweaked if desired. Here I'll increase the font size of the title to make it stand out a bit. And I can now share using all the normal Snagit sharing destinations, but I'm just going to drag this image out of Snagit for later. So I simply drag from the tray and I have the image file that I can drop anywhere that accepts image files. It's super helpful. On Snagit Mac, you still get this faster way of combining and reordering images, but the customization will be coming in a follow-up release in Snagit 2019.
Obviously, you can customize the look and feel a bit now, and one thing we're looking at is how to give you even more stylistic variation for your own use cases in the future. So we spend a lot of time just talking with customers and reading the comments that you post or send us. And we've formalized the process for customers to suggest and upvote enhancements on our community site. We're going to look at two of the most popular requests that we've been able to work on for this version.
The first is the favorite tool. People love the wide range of tools, stamps, and markup styles in Snagit. But as that list grows, we need better ways to keep our most used ones at our fingertips.
Lots of customization is already possible with the toolbar and quick styles, and now we're extending that to give you a single go-to place for all of your most used markup. So if, let's say you find yourself constantly switching between a pink arrow, a green speech bubble, and an orange highlight. Not sure why you would, but you can park them all in your favorites, and this saves you a few clicks when switching between them.
Like Daniel said, it can be pretty time-consuming to switch between tools. So now you can save your favorite quick styles by clicking on a star when you select one. So here I have my red step tool circle. I'm going to click on the star. And when I switch over to favorites, you can see it's now been saved. So I can use the tool and I don't have to switch between the arrow and the callout tools to really mark up my image. All my favorites are now in the same place. I'll use my green arrow here. And this really shines when you're saving your favorite stamps too. So here are a few that are used frequently. And in this example, I could use this approved stamp to let people know that this website was reviewed.
Another enhancement that's driven by customer requests is stamp searching. So when you buy Snagit, you get around 2,000 pre-made graphics of all kinds, icons, symbols, cursors, even emoji. And those can be easily applied on top of your images. And they're really great for marking up screenshots or even building simple infographics.
But finding just the right stamp you need among those 2,000 options has been a bit tough. So here we've added the ability to search and find exactly what you want. So in the stamp tool, you can see a new search bar. And in this example, I'm going to point out where my viewers should focus their attention. So you can see here, new users are up. So I'm going to simply search for the word up and use the graph stamp. User activity isn't exactly where I want, so I'm going to just search for wrong, and I'll use the wrong way stamp. The categories have been simplified here too, so you have fewer categories to hunt through, and if you've created your own stamps, those are still available. One thing we've seen beta users really excited about is being able to search by color as well. So if you think blue will stand out better on your image, you can bring up all the blue stamps with a quick search.
There's not time to show you all the other small but meaningful improvements we've made to Snagit over the past year, like performance, feature parity between Mac and Windows, and some additional languages. But there's one last feature of Snagit 2019 that we want to unveil today, and I'm super excited about this one.
Back in Snagit 2018, we introduced this theme around making it easier to keep your content current. And we added things like text replace, autofill, and smart move. So those features really made it possible for the first time to deconstruct your screenshots and manipulate them at a deeper level. That's cool, useful stuff that previously required high-end image editing tools and a lot of professional knowledge. So today, we want to introduce a new tool in Snagit that continues down that path.
Have you noticed screenshots that look like this? I've been seeing this simplified treatment everywhere, and maybe you have too. So why are content creators using this approach? So there's really three key reasons that marketers and designers have embraced this simplified treatment so quickly. First, it essentially future-proofs your content. So instead of having to update that screenshot every time the user interface changes, you can keep using the simplified image for a lot longer, even as the UI of your product changes over time. Second, for global companies, you can slash your localization costs. So reduce the text in a screenshot, and you reduce the need for a translated version of the image. Third, simplifying a screenshot just makes it, well, simpler for the viewer to focus on the most important part. Let's see how that works in practice.
In this example, there's a lot going on in this screenshot, and I want to focus the viewer's attention on the part we want to explain. We're going to start off using the auto simplify process. I check this box and it analyzes the image to find the text and other objects and replace them with the most dominant colors found in the image. It happens pretty fast and it can be adjusted using the tolerance slider, but the results in this case are acceptable. This saves me a ton of time. It gave me a great starting point, and I'm still going to need to adjust this image to get it where I want, but it'll take me a fraction of the time. The first thing I'm going to do is remove the simplify objects over the area I want to emphasize. So I'll just select those with the move tool and then delete them. Next up, this area on the right still looks pretty complex. So I'll select those and delete them as well. But in its place, I'm going to select the simplify tool's text style here. And it's pretty great. So when I draw this, it will autofill the background and make it blend in. But it will also add individual lines of text based on the height of the object that I just drew. Now, the text in this table is standing out too much, so I'm going to select them again with the Move tool and adjust their fill color to make them blend in. The same here with this text in the tab area above. I'll select those and adjust their fill color. Now, you get the idea of how this process works, and with a few more minutes of tweaking, here's what the final result will be. You can see we've reduced the complexity of this image, so it's easier to focus on the important parts. It's cheaper to localize, and it won't need to be updated as frequently.
As we've shown mockups and beta builds of this Simplify tool to technical writers, the response has generally been, "I want this today," or "Where can I buy this?" So let me just share one quick story. I was talking with a vice president of engagement at a software startup, and believe it or not, he maintains a written guide with about 900 screenshots. You can imagine the headache when the engineers update his product and then half those screenshots have to be replaced because they no longer match the product. Plus, a lot of those original screenshots have real customer data that has to be blurred or deleted every time they're recaptured. It's a total pain. When I showed this vice president the Simplify concept, he got it immediately and saw how it could save him a lot of money.
That's why we're really excited about the impact Snagit 2019 can have on content teams. We want you to get all the benefits of using visuals in content, higher engagement, clearer understanding, and better recall, while reducing the costs of creating, localizing, and maintaining that content. We can't wait to see all the amazing things you do with Snagit 2019.
Thanks, Chris and Daniel. We hope all of you are as excited about this new functionality as we are. Just a reminder, Snagit 2019 will be available on Tuesday, October 23rd for both Mac and Windows. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask them in the comments. Several people are monitoring our socials and will respond to as many of your questions as they can. We are often asked if this will be a free or a paid upgrade. Customers who want to get their hands on Snagit 2019 will find themselves in one of three situations. It's a free upgrade if you're under an active maintenance agreement or if you purchase Snagit between September 21st through October 23rd this year. If you meet one of those qualifications and you purchased directly from TechSmith, we will email you to let you know how you can get your free upgrade. If you qualify for a free upgrade and don't receive an email, be sure to check your spam folder. The email may have landed there.
Right. Otherwise, the upgrade is $24.95 if you've purchased any prior version. Snagit 9, 10, 11, Mac or Windows, it really doesn't matter. Then the standard license price is $49.95 if you're a brand new customer.
If you purchase maintenance when you buy, which is just $12.49, you'll get a year of free upgrades, priority support, and a discount on volume licensing.
And as I said earlier, with our new annual release cadence, there's a lot of great reasons to add maintenance to your purchase.
Keep in mind that for all of the pricing options we just covered, we do have special government and educational pricing as well. We also have volume discounts that can be found on our website. All right, we've anticipated a few questions you might have, and one of those is, how many languages is Snagit available in? Tony, can you help us answer that?
Yeah, absolutely. So Snagit's available in English, German, and as of just this past summer, now French. And we also anticipate adding additional languages in the future to ensure we can help as many users worldwide as possible. But in addition, we're also adding sales and support in those languages to help customers throughout all of the aspects of your Snagit experience.
In the demo, Daniel mentioned that a lot of what has gone into this release came from user feedback. Yep. How can a user go about providing feedback on Snagit?
Yeah, that's a great question. You know, we truly rely on user feedback to assist in the prioritization of what we include in each release. And to facilitate that, we host what we call a feature roundup, where users can submit ideas and vote on features that they would like to see in the new product. So we encourage you all to provide feedback and let us know what matters to you most by visiting feedback.techsmith.com and participate by voting in our upcoming feature roundup later this year.
Great, thank you, Tony. I want to thank you all for joining us today. You can share the video you're watching right now from the Snagit Facebook page. With that, we're going to wrap up this stream. We'll continue to answer questions as long as they keep coming in, and we hope that you'll mark your calendars to catch the release of Snagit 2019 on October 23rd. Thanks.
Thanks, everyone.